everybody, it's me. I'm greenlighting my day. This is a quote I want to share with you that really spoke to me this morning, and I want to unpack it a little bit and encourage you to think about this today. This is a quote from a Facebook page called Growing Bolder. I really like it because it's about people that are growing older and bolder at the same time, not just older. And this is the quote from Norman Cousins. The tragedy of life is not death, but what we let die inside of us while we live. The tragedy of life is not death, but what we let die inside of us while we live. Yeah. That really struck me, sort of like a in the face this morning, which is good because yesterday I had an uncomfortable experience that I won't unpack too much. Let me just say that someone spoke to me in a tone I'd never heard before, and it was actually it was immediately a feeling of shame and inadequacy just flooded my body, and a part of me died. And that's what made me think of that when I saw that. I thought, you know, I don't allow that. I'm not around that kind of an opportunity for it to happen to me, but it did. And I was in a very vulnerable place when it happened. So it was not a good thing. It's something I have to think about. But it's okay. It's okay because it made me remember things like healthy boundaries. So anyway, today what I want to do is stop and think. What is it that we're doing in our lives that are not life-enhancing, life producing good stuff, you know, revelationary, I love that now, fake word I made up, revelationary, like revolutionary, but it's revelation. Yeah. What are those things that are not, I'm not, where am, what am I missing, or what am I allowing through this filter? Like I pictured a colander or a sieve, and what is it that's going to come through that stream of my day today that should be filtered through so that the good, the positive, the affirming, the life growing, challenging, stretching, learning lessons can get through. But not something that's going to numb us, dumb us, down our lives, our spirits, the core of who we are. Is there a place where that you're experiencing some kind of not good, kind of even teeny weeny 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 thing where your dreams are dying, or you're taking a little bit too much abuse from somebody at work or a customer, or there's some kind of habitual, you know, thing that is killing you bit by bit by bit. It's taking life. Instead of giving life, it's sucking life. And sometimes those are so little, we don't even notice them anymore. We've gotten so used to it. But stop and take a check. Stop and look. Take a little check for yourself. What is it in this day that's going to give you life and not take it? It's a lot to think about. I'm really going to spend some time thinking about this because I think it's time to take good stock of the things that are life-affirming and life-producing and energy and creativity-producing and self-love-producing and healthy boundary-producing and things that just make you feel electric when you get up and are ready to take it on. Electric. You know? We're going to be dead soon enough. Life's shorter than you think. I don't want to allow anything that takes me out every day a little more and a little more and a little more and a little more. Love yourself enough to try to see what those things might be if you have any. If you don't have any, that's all the better. But I think we almost have a few things that kind of, like little mice, nibble away and nibble away and nibble away. It's okay to stop and say, go away, mice. No more nibbling. That area is getting swept out. No more crumbs. I guess that's it. You guys have a great day, and I'll see you soon. Peace out.